Hey Flower Tribe, it's Kelly Lehman, and today I'd like to show you how to bring butterflies to your garden with fruit.
If we haven't met yet, it's nice to meet you. My name is Kelly Lehman. I'm the owner of Cranbury Fields Flower Farm here in Cranbury, New Jersey, and I'm here with Lucy, and we love giving you guys fun, free flower tips. So please feel free to subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the bell notification so you know whenever I post another fun, free flower tip video. So let's dive right in.
Butterflies love having nectar. And a lot of times they can't get enough of it from the flowers that you have in your garden because they might either be out of season or there's other pollinators that they're competing with.
You can encourage butterflies to come to your garden by providing some simple foods from your kitchen. So sometimes butterflies enjoy going to over-ripened fruit and they will use their proboscis to suck out the fruit juice like they would with the nectar of a flower. The proboscis is a tube-like feeding structure on their head that's usually coiled up, but when the butterflies go to feed, it unfurls kind of like a tongue and it allows them to suck up some of the flower nectar or the fruit juice. Some of the fruits that butterflies enjoy are pineapples and watermelon, overripe bananas, overripe orange slices. Those are great. Decaying fruits have carbohydrates and minerals that a lot of butterflies love. It's a good idea to put these decaying fruits in your garden during the day because butterflies love to come out when there's lots of sunshine. They're attracted to light. So they'll do most of their feeding in the morning and then in the afternoon. And you want to make sure that you remove those foods from your garden because then you're going to wind up having some visitors like raccoons and other animals that are interested in eating the fruit at night. So I would remove it from the garden at night and then you can replace it with some different fruits in the morning.
So here's what I did here. I took an overripe banana. So it was kind of beat up. It's got the brown spot. So I put this on a plate. Underneath it, I have water because what I'm going to wind up doing is hoisting this plate up on like a little planter rack to make sure that it's not on the ground. But sometimes the ants will still travel up those little stands. And what's going to happen is this water is going to act as a moat. So instead of having ants crawling all over this fruit and all over the honey, all over the bananas, they're going to wind up getting trapped in the water, or they're just going to, you know, not even go for it and then just turn around and go home. And I have a piece of honeycomb in here that they're going to absolutely love. And I have water underneath there because it's just going to turn into like a honey water. Now, you don't have to have honeycomb. I know that's not always something that people have in hand. We happen to have some honey beehives here, so I had that. This is what one of my frames looked like that we harvested some of the honey from, but you can just use regular honey from like, you know, like your local grocery store, like ShopRite.
And then you're just gonna add some of the honey to the water, and then they're gonna come and have a beautiful meal. Your butterflies might even start getting so comfortable that they'll wind up landing on your shoulder. This doesn't happen often, but when it does, it's pretty magical.
It's so nice getting up close to these beautiful creatures. Truly amazing.
I made a free download PDF file for you that lets you know 4 of my must-have flowers for your gardens, and you can grab that in descriptions below.
Thank you so much for joining us in this video, and please feel free to hop on over to my Kelly Lehman's Flower Tribe Facebook group because there's gardeners from all over the world, and they're posting pictures from their own beautiful gardens, and they're asking and answering tons of garden questions over there. So it's a great place for garden enthusiasts to hang out, and it's a wonderful place to learn all about brand new plants. And please feel free to join us over on our Cranbury Fields Instagram page, and also please let us know where you're viewing this from in this great, big, beautiful world. I love to see how our flower tribe is growing around the globe each week. It's so exciting. And I will see you in the next video.